subscribe to my channel, leave a comment requesting a video, and I might just grant your wish. If you watch hockey or are a San Jose Sharks fan, you most likely know that the Sharks are not exactly a playoff team, let alone a cup contender in the West Division. Yet just 2 years ago, they made it all the way to the Western Conference Final in the Final Four in the playoffs, where they ultimately lost to the eventual Stanley Cup champions in the St. Louis Blues. One of the blockbuster trades of that year in the NHL was Ottawa Senators captain Erik Karlsson being dealt to the Sharks in exchange for a bulk goods package which notably included Chris Tierney, Dylan DeMello, Josh Norris, Rudolph Spalsers, and three draft picks which were a second round pick in 2019, a first round pick in 2020, and a conditional second round pick in 2021. Erik Karlsson himself was a franchise superstar defenseman for the Senators, being the core of their back end for almost a decade and establishing himself as the most dynamic player in the history of their franchise and one of the greatest offensive defensemen in the NHL. He also led the team to a surprising Eastern Conference Final playoff run in 2017, where they ultimately fell to the Pittsburgh Penguins in Game 7 double overtime.
That one came off Stahlberg. It's Schultz working it back in deep. Fresh from the bench, it's Crosby. Crosby on Kunitz, it's shot. Penguins win it! And they go to the final!
Although this goal still causes pain for Sens fans, it's reminiscent of the team's potential during this time, because the team disintegrated into absolute hell for the next few seasons, as the majority of the players from this historic run were either traded or vanished like Ted Cruz during the Texas power outages. So although more than one eyebrow was raised when Karlsson was dealt to Silicon Valley in 2018, the Sens were forced to rebuild as they began to occupy the bottom of the league standings and keep the Detroit Red Wings company in the basement. In San Jose, Karlsson has not scored like at the rate he did in Ottawa, but he still managed to put up tons of assists and respectable point totals for an offensive defenseman. Looking at his seasons with the Sharks, he's put up 17 goals and 90 assists for 107 points in 161 games. And while those numbers are not comparable to those that he racked up in Ottawa, they are still respectable for a premier offensive defenseman. This should also be looked at in context, because Erik Karlsson is in a new environment, was still trying to grasp with his son Axel being stillborn, and has been battling with some significant injuries during that time. Let's not forget the whole controversy surrounding Karlsson and Mike Hoffman's god-awful excuse for a girlfriend targeting his wife. Karlsson was doing well in San Jose, maybe not as well as in Ottawa, but he was still usable with large minutes when he was healthy. Hopefully San Jose doesn't screw up this signing. And then San Jose does this. 8 years, $92 million. For a guy who is a shell of his former self due to mainly injuries, what in the generic vanilla of Owen Nolan's name was Doug Wilson thinking? Was he shooting H while he gave this contract? I'd get it if you were getting the Norris Karlsson or the 82-point Karlsson in 2016, but this? I would have said $7 million at 5 to 6 years for a reasonable amount. Not $11.5 million for eight. Because of the bloated contract, the Sharks had to deal Joe Pavelski, their captain, leader, and heart of the franchise, to the Stars, and boy was his departure noticeable to the Sharks. As for the return that Ottawa received, Chris Tierney is having some of his most productive seasons in Canada's capital, considering that in San Jose he was used as a bottom six forward. Rudolph Spalsers is back with the San Jose Sharks after two mediocre seasons with last place Ottawa, and considering the seasons he had in Ottawa, he's doing much better with the Sharks. Dylan DeMello had his best season in Ottawa in 2018-2019, being paired on the top line with Thomas Chabot, and is now a depth piece for Winnipeg's back end. Josh Norris, however, is making San Jose look like an absolute idiot for trading him, as he is having one hell of a rookie season with Ottawa, and looks to be a critical part of their rebuild, as his place in the top six is guaranteed at this point. With the draft picks Ottawa collected from the trade, the 2019 second round was some random schmuck no one's ever heard of that didn't even go to Ottawa, rather he went to the bunch of jerks in Carolina. The 2020 first rounder didn't seem like it would have killed the Sharks at the time of the trade, since they weren't really in a rebuilding phase. However, that all changed when the Senators used the pick to draft someone whose name happened to be Tim Stützle, third overall. Failure by proxy. The only way that this would be worse is if the 2021 second round pick, which Ottawa received when Karlsson re-signed an 8-year extension with the Sharks, turns out like Nils Höglander did for Vancouver. Then Doug Wilson can officially wear the dunce hat. Not proudly. So to sum up the massive trade, currently, San Jose is just left with Erik Karlsson, as Francis Perron is currently under contract with IF Björklöven of Hockey Allsvenskan in Sweden.
Meanwhile,
Ottawa currently has Chris Tierney, Josh Norris, Tim Stützle, and a second round pick in 2021. As for who won the trade, you decide for yourself. Personally, I think that if Karlsson didn't get injured as much as he did in San Jose and retained his strong Norris form, then San Jose might have won the trade. But I have to say that Ottawa, who have been going through a large rebuilding phase, may have just struck gold here, especially with drafting Tim Stützle, who wasn't even their original pick. The Ottawa Senators originally had the 5th overall pick, which they used to select Jake Sanderson, who looks to be an integral part of Ottawa's back end. However, they received the 3rd overall pick as well from the trade, and along with Sanderson, they now have one of the best German prospects in the entire league. As much as I'm a Sharks fan, I have to give this trade to Ottawa. Thank you.